Welcome to Sky DRM for Teamcenter demo. In this demo, we will be applying Teamcenter user attributes and ADA license to protect files. In the first use case, we will protect a dataset and files based on ADA license and grant access rights to these files downloaded from Teamcenter based on authorized users of the ADA license. In use case 2, we will grant access rights to DRM protected files based on Teamcenter user attributes such as government clearance. In the final use case, we will show when a file is DRM protected based on ADA license. Access rights will expire automatically when the ADA license expires. We will now move on to use case 1, where authorized users are granted permission to view files governed by ITAR license TAA01. We begin this demo as user admin, who is logged into Teamcenter Rich application client. I will then go to the ADA license interface. I select TAA01. As you can see, the license type is ITAR and the license ID is set to TAA01. We will add John Tyler and TC Admin as authorized users, allowing them to have access to files governed by the TAA01 license. I will then click Modify to enact these changes. Because SkyDRM is integrated with Teamcenter, admin has the ability to configure the NXL transferred attributes list. Admin is able to define which attributes are used to protect files. Here we will configure the license list and owning groups. When the files are protected in Teamcenter, the value of the two attributes in the configuration will be used to determine the classification of the file, which will be used by the policy to determine the permissions. Now in the SkyDRM console, admin will view the policy titled Grant Authorized Users View Rights on Documents Governed by TAA01 License. Let's click on it to see how the policy is defined. In this policy, you can see that authorized users of a document with TAA01 license will be granted view permissions. As John Tyler, we log into Teamcenter user interface and will check the license of this dataset. I right-click, select License, then Attach. As we can see, the TAA01 license is attached to this dataset. I will now protect said dataset with NextLabs SkyDRM. A new translation request for this dataset has been created. Let's confirm that the file has been protected. It has been protected. Upon refreshing the Rich application client user interface, you can see that the file has a new protected icon. Let's check the name reference. And you can see that the new protected file has been created with the TAA01 license and the other attribute value added to the protected file. John Tyler proceeds to download this protected file to the shared folder. Now, user tcadmin accesses the shared folder and sees a document that has been shared. Let's check the file properties and permissions granted to tcadmin. We can confirm that the TAA01 license and other attributes such as owning group have been transferred and stayed with the documents. As specified in the policy, TC Admin, who is an authorized user of TAA01 license, has view permissions on this document. Let's make sure TC Admin indeed has access to the file. I will double-click to open the file and am able to view the contents of the file. Now, let me show how the permissions granted on the file will be automatically adjusted when the TAA01 license is modified. In this case, user TCAdmin is no longer qualified as an authorized user for TAA01 license. With this, the admin removes user TCAdmin from TAA01 license. Let's see what happens when user TCAdmin tries to access the same protected file in the shared folder. As you can see here, TCAdmin is denied access from the file because, according to the policy, only users who are authorized by TAA01 license are able to access the file. In use case 2, I will show you how to apply a user attribute such as government clearance to determine permission to a file. We will begin this segment as admin user, called InfoDBA, who logs into Teamcenter Rich Application Client to review the profile of each user. We will begin by going to the organization interface to look at the value of the government clearance of the users in this use case. For this demo, we will use John Tyler, TCAdmin, and Jimmy Carter. Let's look at the government clearance for each of these users. Once on the page, click on Users, and then select John Tyler. As you can see, John Tyler's government clearance is secret, whereas other user TCAdmin's government clearance is top secret. Jimmy Carter's government clearance is super secret. By assigning different values of a government clearance attribute, it allows different permissions to be granted to the file. Now I log into SkyDRM Admin Console as admin user. I have already created 3 policies. The first policy is called Allow Top Secret User to have the view and edit rights on protected files. The second policy is called Allow Super Secret Users to have full rights on protected files. And the final policy is titled Allow Secret User to have view rights on protected files. Let's look at the content of the first policy. In this policy, we will use government clearance attribute of the user to grant permission to the file. For the user with the value of the government clearance attribute of top secret, edit and view permissions will be granted. John Tyler logs into Teamcenter Rich Application Client. He sees the protected data set 00512A, which he will download to a shared folder for further collaboration with Jimmy Carter and TCAdmin. He opens the downloaded protected file in the shared folder with NX and SkyDRM client software. Double-clicking on the protected file will automatically launch the NX application. Once the file is opened in NX, the user will now be able to work on the protected file freely with the NX RMX add-ons. The add-on provides functionality to view the file rights. John Tyler checks the file rights and sees that he only has view permissions. When John Tyler attempts to edit the file, he receives a message that states he only has read permissions. This is because his government clearance is secret. User TCAdmin has access to the shared folder and will open the same protected file, causing NX to automatically launch. He checks the file rights and determines he has view and save permissions. Since he is able to edit the file, he makes a change to the part. And saves it. The save operation was completed successfully. User Jimmy Carter now logs in and opens the same protected file. As expected, NX launches automatically, and he uses the NX RMX add-on to view his rights. He has full permissions, just as specified in the policy, due to his government clearance being equal to super secret. In the final use case, we will review rights expiration regarding the Sky DRM integration with Teamcenter. In this use case, export control policy governs the rights expiration, causing those whose export control license expired to no longer be able to view protected files. We begin this segment as user admin, who logs into Teamcenter Rich application client and is in the ADA license window. We will now view the ITAR license TAA02. As you can see, the license type is ITAR, and the license identification is TAA02. This license is set to expire on November 12, 2021 at 3 p.m. and is granted to user Jimmy Carter. Normally, a license as such would be set to expire at midnight. However, for the demo, the expiration time of 3 p.m. is used. We will now view the dataset. As you can see, the dataset is governed by license TAA02. I will now go to named reference and download the file into a shared folder. Now, admin logs into Sky DRM console. As you can see, there is a policy titled Grant Authorized User View Rights on Documents Governed by TAA02 License and License Expiration. Let's click on it to see how the policy is defined. The license for this policy is set to TAA02, allowing authorized users to have view permissions on files governed by this license. As user Jimmy Carter, we will go to the shared folder and check the permissions of the downloaded file. Because Jimmy Carter is an authorized user under license TAA02, he has view permissions as the license has not expired. I will double-click to view this file. It opens and allows me to successfully view the content. This is because the time of access is before 3 p.m. on November 12th, which is when the license is set to expire. Subsequently, Jimmy Carter tries to access the same file after TAA02 license expired. He is no longer able to access the file as it is 3:01 p.m. on November 12th, and he is attempting to access the file after the date of expiration has passed. This concludes the use case series. Thank you for watching.